exacqVision can archive data to a pre-configured SMB share drive, such as those on an exacqVision S-Series storage server. The archiving page allows you to configure exacqVision to back up recorded data for quick retrieval from any client machine using the search page. Archiving is different from extended storage in that a drive used for extended storage is used as if it is a disk installed in the system. New data is written to it and exists in a single place. In archiving, a copy of the data on the exacqVision system is created on the storage target. This acts as a backup to chosen data. In some instances, depending on storage capacity, retention rules, and archiving configuration, the archived data may permit data to be retained further back than on the recording system. Multiple archiving profiles may be created. Click the New button at the bottom left. A saved profile may be disabled without deleting it by unchecking the enabled box at a later date. The Type drop-down menu provides some options for the location of your archived data. SMB allows you to utilize a networked SMB share directory on your network. Note that only one exact system may use a share directory. If you intend to archive multiple systems, you must create separate share directories for each to use. Type in the path to the archive target folder. Enter the username and password if required to log into the shared network drive. The percentage to use slider will allow you to configure the amount of space on the drive that should be used for archiving. In this example, we will use 50% of the drive for archiving data. The desired content age setting is used in the same manner as that on the storage page. If you were to set the desired content age below to 60 days, and the oldest content on the archive drive is 55 days, the system would trigger an alarm. Archiving also provides an at-most expiration configuration similar to that on the storage page for adhering to local regulations if needed. The direct search region is optional. This is a feature allowing client workstations to connect directly to the archive, but they must have a direct network path to reach the archive. This can potentially speed up video downloads, reduce network bandwidth usage when searching, or enable archive video to be searched even if the recording exact server is offline. Enter user credentials for accessing this archive here. Refer to the separate direct search video for more details. Click Apply to save your changes. While archiving to SMB targets is the default and supported by exacqVision S-Series, other archiving types are available as well. Cloud Drive is a subscription plan available in server client versions 21.12 and above and is offered by exact dealers for off-site cloud-based storage. Amazon S3 targets are supported by server client versions 20.12 and above. Archiving to Wasabi S3 targets was added in 24.09. And lastly, NFS may be used for customer-provided systems that support this protocol, but manual steps could be involved on your system to use NFS, as noted in our Knowledge Base article. With an archive target now created, you may configure the archive task. The archive target defines where the archive data will be located, while the archive task tells the system when to begin archiving the data. Click New and enter a name for the configuration. This example will be set to begin the task at 1 a.m. For the end time configuration, selecting Continuous will tell the system to scan for new data to be archived every 5 minutes. Select Until Finished if you want the archiving task to run until no new data is found, and then stop until the next scheduled time period. Selecting User Defined allows you to set a stop time, even if it has not completed archiving all data. This can be useful if you must free up system or network resources during certain times of the day. For example, if performing archiving overnight, when new recording and network traffic is at its lowest point for most buildings, you may use this to cease archiving before office users begin work again in the morning, requiring more network bandwidth and higher disk throughput. Note, however, that if the archiving cannot complete archiving all new data day after day, it's possible to encounter gaps in archived data where older data is removed from the recording system before it is able to be archived. If selecting Until Finished or User Defined, you'll be able to set the frequency of the specific days you wish the archiving to run. With both the archive target and tasks done, you will now select the specific data you want to archive. Navigate to the Schedule tab. On the Schedule tab, select Days. Highlight the sources you wish to configure. In this example, we will select all sources. Clicking the green All button will set all selected sources to archive all data. Click on Set to apply this configuration to all days and click Apply. You may also view the schedule options by sources. Select a camera, then select the boxes for the days and times you want to archive. Here, we will select Monday through Friday from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. This time, we will select the blue motion button so that only motion recording data will be archived during business hours. You can combine different settings for different days and hours. Here, we select all the days and hours outside business hours using the control key to select multiple days and hours, and we'll click the red alarm button to archive all data recorded based on an alarm. Keep in mind that record settings and archive settings do not have to be configured for the same type of data. As an example, you could record free run video on a system at a certain time, but then choose to archive only the motion video recorded data during the same period.